Hi, One Best PR Videos. I'm Peter Loschak. Today is Tuesday, April 12th. The futures odds for the Stanley Cup and to win the Eastern and Western conferences in the NHL playoffs are finally out. And we are going to talk with contributing NHL handicapping writer Dana Lane to get his take on these odds. Dana, I'm going to be quoting Pinnacle odds here, the last Pinnacle odds I saw. But of course, these lines will move, and line shopping can get a lot of value, a lot of extra value when it comes to futures odds like these. Let's start with the Eastern Conference. You know, the Capitals, of course, won the President's Trophy, an awesome team. They're up, they're 5-on-5. Their even strength shot metrics are a little bit unspectacular, shall we say. But then you look at, and they're plus 163 at Pinnacle, the last odds I saw. And then if you look down the other teams in the East, who can beat them? All of the teams that would normally have a good shot have injury concerns, right? The Penguins, injuries. The Rangers have bad shot metrics. So Detroit Red Wings, bad goal differential. Tampa Bay, injuries. Islanders, injuries. Maybe the Florida Panthers at about 6.5 to 1 have the best shot of upsetting Washington. What do you think?
Yeah, Pete, it's awesome that you use shot metrics because I love all those statistics. I mean, they're if you know how to actually read those stats, those are really big-time telling stats about where the team is going. And even better, you can get a lot of those statistics within the last 5 to 10 games. So a lot of times you can't always just say, okay, well, a team is like the Washington Capitals all year, have had fantastic numbers. But then in the last week, it's a completely different story. And you're absolutely right about this, Pete. I mean, the Washington Capitals deserve to be the number one seed, and they certainly are the number one seed in the Eastern Conference. But for me, again, it's what have I seen the last 2 weeks out of them? And is this a team that has a switch to turn it up a notch when the playoffs start? I've seen this team lose and get shut out by Arizona, a team, even if they did reduce numbers, they have no business even being in the same, or Arizona has no business being in the same ice with Washington. So right. I'm very interested to see against a Philadelphia team that's going to just come in and be as physical as possible. I think the Capitals have a very difficult road to the finals because even if they pass Philadelphia, oh, by the way, here comes the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, my sense is that one of the best bets in terms of value to unseat Washington might actually come in the first round against the Flyers. You talk about some of those advanced shot metrics, and the Flyers actually, especially over the last 25 games, have some great advanced shot metrics. So you know, that's a very telling sign.
And you know, beat Washington last time they played.
I'm sorry?
And beat Washington the last time they played.
Absolutely, and one of Washington's big advantages is on special teams. That's also the notable weakness of the Flyers, and of course, conventional wisdom says that that gets mitigated a bit in the playoffs. So would you say then that that the Capitals are not a good bet at the current odds of about plus 160?
I don't want anything to do with the Washington Capitals. I still need to see. I mean, look, Pete, if this series goes 5 games, Then we might be talking a different story because maybe, as we saw against St. Louis the other night, the Capitals do have the ability to turn it back up again, but then they lay an egg in their last game of the season. So I'm not sure what I'm getting with Washington. And like we've said 100 times on these videos, the Capitals have to have some sense of accomplishment because of the President's Trophy victory. And I'm just very leery of putting my money behind a President's Cup winner.
All right, and the three teams with major injury issues are, you know, the Penguins, the Lightning, and the Islanders. Is that a major factor there, or do you think that that the injuries actually will prove to ultimately not be that big of a deal in the playoffs for any one of those teams?
Well, it doesn't seem to be a problem for Pittsburgh. Obviously, with Malkin out, numerically, we look at that loss and say, wow, what a big loss, especially on the power play unit. But you know what? They have a great luxury in Pittsburgh. There's kind of a logjam of talent in Pittsburgh. And now we get to finally see Phil Kessel on a line that matches his speed. And the logjam is finally kind of loosened a little bit. So they might be even a little bit better offensively with a few injuries. And they certainly do have a lot. But against the Rangers, they even with the injuries, they're a much better team than the Rangers. I don't know what Lundqvist I'm going to get night in, night out. And then we're looking at a second round matchup against the Capitals, and all bets are off at that point. I think Washington's a better team, But let's see how both of those teams come out of these series.
Yeah, it does seem like with the coaching change, this is sort of like not the Penguins of old, and that they might actually be a team that does well in the playoffs. This year, they are plus 451 right now, 9-2 to win the East. All right, and what's your take on Tampa Bay? You know, a quality team that made the Stanley Cup Finals last year, but Ben Bishop in goal is obviously a huge plus. Injury's a big concern. Are you throwing them out because of that?
No, I think Tampa Bay, I think Tampa Bay is going to beat Detroit. I'm not a huge fan of Jeff Blashill's team. Right. I watched that game the other night again, the last time that they played, and Tampa beat them 4-2. And there was too many defensive breakdowns, and that's kind of been the theme for the Red Wings all year. I don't need a team that's going to break down defensively going into the playoffs. So even with the injuries, I feel like they're a better team. And one thing that Tampa's done that they didn't do last year is they've limited the opposing team's high quality scoring opportunities, and that I think is going to carry them in the first round. But I think in the second round, that's where they're going to have problems against Florida.
All right. So before we move on to the West, let's get a value play as of the odds right now from you, Dana Lane. Would it be the Capitals at plus 160? We've got the Penguins at about 9-2, plus 451. Florida Panthers plus 660. Tampa Bay plus 908. Maybe like the Flyers at about 14.5-1. What would your value play be to win the East?
Pete, I have to tell you, I love the way the Panthers play. Mm-hmm. And here's the thing. I've buried them a couple times, and I thought, well, you know, we have a 44-year-old that's leading your team and Roberto Luongo that's so up and down mentally. But here's a team that has lost that division lead twice to Tampa Bay and Boston and twice came back to win to overtake both of those teams. And not only overtake them, completely easily win that division. I like where they're at as a team right now. You're getting fantastic odds. I've seen as high as 20-1 in some spots. And considering the Capitals would probably be their chief rival in the playoffs, you know, Washington's got to go through Pittsburgh. And after they go through Pittsburgh, I'm not sure what they're going to have left against Florida. I think Florida's going to be in a good shot and in a good spot, only having to go through the Islanders and a depleted Tampa Bay Lightning team.
Right. That's what I was thinking as well. Florida right now plus 660 at Pinnacle. And again, if you shop around, you can probably get a better line. These lines will move, of course. Now let's move on to the West. Dana Lane, have you ever seen futures odds to win of the Western Conference or the Eastern Conference in the NHL that are this bunched up? There's no favorite here, right? Right now at Pinnacle, Dallas, Anaheim, the Kings, and St. Louis all have identical odds at 9-2. And then the fifth choice is the Chicago Blackhawks at plus 541. There's no favorite in the West.
Yeah, and what's funny about that, Pete, is if you shop around, there's actually some books that have the Blackhawks as the first favorite.
Sure.
So it's very important to shop around. But look, we talk about value all the time. And guys, let's not make this any harder than it is. Who do you think is going to win the West? And who do you think is going to win the East? And right. If you think that team's going to win, that's where the value is.
Right.
It's, you know, and it's like, don't put money down and cross your fingers. Put money down on the team that you think is going to win. But when we look at the West, Pete, I mean, we have first round matchups. And somebody's going home, and those teams going home, if they were in the East, could easily get through the East to go to the Cup. So I think the interesting matchup to me is San Jose and L.A. And an L.A. team that would much rather play their games on the road, or at least their record indicates they'd rather play away from SAP. And like we said yesterday, I think they're a tick above Los Angeles. I don't like the way L.A. finished their season. So that would be... in that series, San Jose would be my choice. And of course, we go to Dallas and Minnesota, and we found out today that Zach Parise will not be available for Minnesota, their leading scorer. So Minnesota's done. There's no way I would put money on them, regardless of what their odds are. And St. Louis and Chicago is certainly an intriguing matchup as well. And I know St. Louis had their number, but I'm still going to go with pedigree here until, mm-hmm. A man that you and I might know has said, to be the man, you have to beat the man. And I feel like Chicago is the man at this point until they get beat.
Yeah, I mean, they're getting a little bit old there, and their puck possession stats have been declining year by year, but you still think that, their playoff pedigree is going to be the key factor here.
Yeah, and Pete, look, the St. Louis organization has not got past the second round in 15 years. There's something that happens between the regular season and postseason that does not allow them to flip up that extra switch, that right. extra notch that teams need to be successful in the playoffs. And St. Louis, as an organization, just has never had that. And I can, and going against the, in into this series, we've seen Chicago flip that switch many, many times, and they're on their way to winning 3-6, maybe, if they win this year. That's amazing, and I can't go against that.
All right, and Dallas, the top seed Dallas at 9-2, you're throwing them out because of just goaltending issues. They don't have the team makeup that you like to see when you want to bet someone to get to the Stanley Cup Finals.
I love Dallas, Pete. I love Dallas.
Oh, okay.
And the reason why I like Dallas is finally we see Niemi and Lehtinen finally playing well, especially Niemi, who's probably it's going to get the start tomorrow night. If they can get solid goaltending.
Oh, yeah, then it's a different story.
Yeah, even with Sagan out of the lineup, again, sometimes there's addition by subtraction. And I think Dallas has gone into the postseason winning 8 out of the last 10. And the teams that are hot going into the playoffs, that's the team usually you'd want to ride.
Okay. And St. Louis, you see another playoffs fail from St. Louis?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, they have the fewest goals per game of any team remaining in the playoff hunt, which is saying something considering how inept Anaheim is.
Yeah.
Backes is aging. Steen, I don't know if he's 100%. And at the trade deadline, Doug Armstrong decided not to address any of these issues, and now I think it's going to come back to bite them. I just don't man to man. Pedigree for pedigree, they're not as good as the Chicago Blackhawks.
Okay, and what about San Jose? If you like San Jose to get by the Kings, San Jose is right now 11-1 at Pinnacle to win the West.
Yeah, and I like them to get past Anaheim as well. We talked about, Pete, that I've never been a huge fan of the Ducks. Yes, this is what the Ducks do. They get a lead, and they put four guys up at the blue line and
right.
dare you to beat them. Okay, that to me is... That's 20 years ago hockey. That's New Jersey Devil hockey. That's not the way things are today. I mean, you're going to have teams that are going to use their speed. They either get the puck in the neutral zone or in the offensive zone and through the neutral zone. And if that doesn't work, I think they're going to use their speed to get to the corners faster in a dump and chase game. I just don't see where the Ducks on a consistent basis can go through. They will beat Nashville. But make no mistake about that. But I don't think they're going to beat San Jose, and they're not as fast as Dallas. That's a tough road for me to back a team that can't score.
All right, well, a ton of talent in the West and not at all clear who should be the favorite. Let's get a tentative pick from you, Dana Lane. We've got Dallas, Anaheim, the Kings, and St. Louis again, all at 9-2. The Blackhawks at +541, and then San Jose at 11-1, Nashville 12-1, Minnesota 16-1. Who would your pick be to win the West?
For me, it's going to be Dallas because it's the easiest road, especially if they start getting goaltending. With Parise out, I think this is probably a 4 or maybe a 5-game series against Minnesota, resting them. You have a Kings team that is going up against San Jose, which is going to be extremely physical. And then you have Anaheim and in my projections, at least, Anaheim and San Jose, which is also going to be physical. And we've seen that Dallas has had success against Chicago. Let's see how Chicago comes out of a tough series against St. Louis. And I think when it's all said and done, with Dallas having home ice advantage, I think that's the difference against the Sharks, even though they're extremely good on the road.
Okay, yeah, the top seed in the West, currently 9-2, +451, just to win the West, not even to win it all. Dana Lane, thanks so much for your very insightful thoughts, as always.
Happy to do it, Pete. Thank you for your time.